Hey fellow animators, I'm Milos Cerny. Let's take a look at some things in CAD that you might have not used before or maybe even didn't know they are there at all. Let's start with Digit Manager for Palm. If you create an arm bone chain in CAD, let's do a quick rig here. Add arm to pelvis and for its palm create some digits. Let's say 5. Digits are fingers in our case, so now we have 5 fingers created. However, the interesting part is that now, with palm bone selected, you can go to motion panel and there at the bottom you will see a digit manager. Let's switch to a model so we can see it in practice. Here we have an already familiar Hiroshima mech model. You will find a similar user interface as the saving and loading of animation clips or poses has. We can now save the palm pose, which will save all the fingers. Let's call it default. And you can see it already appeared in the UI window. Let's do a different pose real quick, where he is holding this cylinder for example. Something like this. And again, save it as mech holding. Now we can instantly switch between these saved poses without any more work. It will of course work on the other side as well, and even between different characters. If not precisely, it can give you a base at least. So you can theoretically create a small database of poses and reuse them. Second thing, layer transform gizmo. Let's say we have two characters like these with different movement animations done. These are both collapsed absolute layers with keys on each frame. For every absolute layer in CAD, you can activate layer transform gizmo, which is this button here. And it will display this small box for the layer, which you can now select and move or rotate. It will completely offset the whole layer together with the animation in it, which is very useful when you have more characters in a scene, or maybe when you import a character into a big scene with environment and you just want to place him somewhere properly. You can even animate this. You can see that the mech is now sliding till frame 90, because he is moving with the animation, but with the animated transform gizmo as well. Which is not very practical example, but the point is, it is animatable. Third thing, local weights for animation layers. So, here in this file we have two animation layers. A blue one with the walk animation, and red one where we have just a single pose, no animation. And in this pose he holds his arms up front. Now what we can do? For the walk layer, after selecting one of the bones from the arm, we can lower the local weight value down to 0, and we can see that the arm rises up like we had in the red layer. But the rest of the animation still keeps playing. We can also see the 0 weight value for the blue layer, which means that now the left arm is animated by the red layer. We can do the same for the other arm, and this could be a principle of how to animate a character holding a box for example, or something else. But not just that, if you need to blend an animation of an animal with 4 legs for example, from walk to run, with this you can blend each leg in a different time if you need to. The fourth thing is kind of related to the last one, coloring of the layers. When you go to this button and switch the recoloring mode, it will recolor the bones according to the color of their layers. And now you can immediately visually see which layer affects which bone, which is really useful when you blend different stuff between lots of layers. And the fifth and last thing for now, the whole LinkInfo tab inside Hierarchy panel. If you watch my videos, we have already set up some things here before, but what you need to know is that if you are looking for some CAD bone settings, they are probably here. You can disable inheriting of parameters here, enable or disable stretching of the bones, lock and unlock transformations, or a lot of other stuff. You should keep this in mind that this is where you find most of the settings for CAD bones. Okay, and that's it for today. Hopefully you have found something useful in here, and if some of this was new to you, now you can start using it in your next project. Thank you, and thank you to all my Patreons, and see you in the next video. I am Milos Cerny, and thank you for watching.